Okay, this is video number one for the module on growth. And here's the outline for growth. What we're going to do in this video is just go over the importance of the growth rate and how productivity is related to the growth rate. And something important that you need to understand is the difference between the level of income in a country versus the growth rate of income. And then we'll go over the productivity slowdown that occurred a while ago. Okay, so one way to represent growth is using the PPF. So I'll draw the PPF for an economy, and we can put boats and bananas on the axis, or we can put investment and consumption on the axis. And we'll draw our PPF, which is bowed outward from the origin. And our potential output, potential, is right on the edge of the PPF. And if we've got idleness like unemployment, then we are inside the PPF. And that production, or that PPF, is determined by the production function, remember, where our output, and our symbol for output is capital Y, is some function of a whole bunch of inputs. And generally, we write those inputs as labor and capital and human capital and technology. So we grow in the economy, and that makes this PPF shift outward. And more important than just growth is really output per capita. So we want our output per person or per capita, Y per capita, to grow. Now let me show you the importance of what this growth rate means. That's what we generally look at. Not just that we're growing, but what is the rate of growth? And little bits of an increase in the growth rate actually can make quite a bit of importance. So let me take a couple of countries and look at them over time and show you the difference. So South Korea, I'll put here, and Philippines, I'll put over here. 1L, 2Ps, 3Ps actually. And in 1960, they had the same output per person. So the same income per person. So 1960, pretty much the same, which meant the same standard of living in both countries. Then from 1960 to 1991, so 30 years, South Korea grew at 6.2% a year. And the Philippines grew at 1.8% a year. Now that doesn't sound like very much growth, doesn't sound like a lot of difference in the growth, but by 1991, the income or output per person in South Korea was three times as much as the Philippines. So essentially, people were three times as rich in South Korea 30 years later than people in the Philippines, only because they grew at about 4% a year more than the Philippines. And they continued to grow. By 2012, at that time, in 2012, put into a dollar amount of their income per person was $32,000 a year, $32,800, and it was $4,500 in the Philippines, meaning that their income per person was 7.3 times as much. So they left Philippines in the dust. Philippines stayed a poor country. South Korea managed to catch up with the rest of the world and the developing countries. Now take a look at this chart here. On the left shows the annual average growth rates in a country of their output. And over there on the right is the number of years for incomes to double. Now when incomes double, it basically means the standard of living doubles. We'll get more into how you measure output later on. That's in the module with gross domestic product, GDP, which measures output for the economy. Now, the USA, we're right about here. Per person. Our growth rate is here, about 3%, but the population's increasing. So per capita, we grow at about 2%. So this is the USA, and this is the USA output per capita. For the last 100 years, we've been growing about 3% a year. That's our normal growth rate. And that's the one that people compare what's going on right now to. It's like, well, if we're growing at an annual rate of greater than 3%, the economy's doing pretty good. 4% is fantastic. If we're growing at 2% a year annual rate, that's not so great. 1%, that's actually kind of terrible. So all the numbers that come out with our growth rates are usually compared to 3% to see how we're doing. Now, some countries like South Korea, here the USA, we're right here, they're doubling. Our incomes are doubling every 35 years. Right here, 7% is South Korea, Taiwan, Singapore, the Asian Tigers. And you can see that their standard of living is doubling. Their income per person is doubling about every 10 years. China, for a long time, was just way off the charts. They were growing somewhere around 12% a year, per capita output of around 10%. Lately, they've been slowing down. Last numbers I saw weren't all that great, maybe 5 or 6. Still not bad. Some people were doubting their numbers to see if that's really true, but it may not be exactly 10 or 11 or 12 or 13, but whatever it is, it's a phenomenal amount because you can see how the standard of living has been increasing in the countries. They went from riding, walking to bicycles, to scooters, to BMWs fairly quickly. So they've obviously been growing at a very rapid rate. Now, the reason why some countries are richer than others, or they have more income per person per year, is that the workers are more productive in those countries. So productivity is defined as output per worker. Little different than output per capita, because output per capita means the number of people in the country. Output per worker is just the number of workers in the country, and not everybody's working. Only maybe 2/3 or so of the population is actually working. And this is sometimes written as output over L, and that L is usually in labor hours, like 1 hour. Usually 1 hour. So this is output per labor hours. And it's calculated in 1 hour increments because not all countries work the same. number of hours per week. So in the US, we work, a normal work week is 40 hours, but a lot of poor countries, third world countries, developing countries, frequently work 60 hours a week, or definitely 6 days a week. They work a lot more. So we have to look at their productivity per hour. How much can a worker produce in 1 hour? And the more that a worker can produce in 1 hour means the higher standard of living that that country has. So if we want to grow, we have to increase worker productivity. This is the key. An increase in productivity is what defines and causes growth. The workers have to become more productive, and there really was very little growth before the Industrial Revolution. There wasn't much change in productivity. The only way countries grew is by having more people come to the country. But then that doesn't improve people's standard of living if they grow only by labor. Our output per person doesn't change. Now we have to distinguish here between the level of income versus the growth rate of income. There's a difference. So take US and China. The standard of living is higher in the US than in China. China's down here. And the reason why is because the workers in the US are more productive in an hour than the workers in China. Now, in order for them to catch up, they have to grow faster. If we all grow at the same rate, then they're always going to be behind. If a poor country is going to catch up with a rich country, they have to grow faster than the rich country to catch up. So now we've got a 3% growth rate each year, and China is more like 10%. See, that doesn't mean that China is a richer country. It just means they're catching up. They're growing faster. If they can keep up that growth rate, then they will catch up. And if they can keep that growth rate up after they catch up, then they can continue on to have a higher standard of living. It's like two runners. If the one in back is going to catch up to the runner in front before the finish line, the runner in the back has to run faster than the runner in front. If they run at the same speed, then they'll never catch up. Now, because growth and productivity is the key to growth, and if we want to grow, that means productivity has to grow. Economists want to look at the growth rate of productivity in countries and see how that's moving, because that's going to give a key here to how fast we're going to be growing. And productivity doesn't always grow at the same rate. Changes a little bit. In 1972, there was what was called a productivity slowdown. Productivity was still increasing, but not at the same rate. And so from 1972 to 1995, there was this period where productivity wasn't growing very fast. Let me show you a graph. Let's see if I can find it right here. Here's the growth rates of a bunch of different countries here from 1948 to 72. And you can see how fast they were growing. And then see how fast they were growing from 1972 to 1995. And Canada went from about 3% to under 2%. France went from 4% to 1.5%. West Germany almost 6% to 2%. Italy from 5% to 2.5%. It wasn't just in the United States. It was all over the world. Japan went from over eight to 2.5%. US fell, but only from 2.2 to 1.5. So it's called the productivity slowdown. Why did it happen? Economists would like to know. Nobody really knows just why it would happen. You would think from 72 to 1995, when computers were coming of age, that we should have been becoming a whole lot more productive. But that's not what happened. But then in 1995, something started to change. Productivity started to go back up again. And guess what it was called? It was called the productivity speed up. And once again, economists don't really know why. They know there are a lot of productivity improvements in retail. Some say the productivity speed up was due to Walmart. If you look at the productivity of a Walmart employee versus an employee from a smaller store, say Rite Aid, take a look at the checker at Rite Aid and the checker at Walmart and see how much they go through in a day, how much they sell. You can see, wow, the checker at Walmart is quite productive. But it's not clear exactly what caused that slowdown to happen. Okay, that's the end of video one. And we've gone over just how important the growth rate is to economists and how productivity is related to that growth rate. And make sure you understand that there's a difference here between the level of income in a country, which determines the standard of living, and the growth rate of income in a country, how fast that income is rising. They're both different. Okay, so in the next video, we'll go start in on the issues in growth.